introducing Thermo-Calc 2019B, which includes a new module that makes it easy to set up calculations for steel and slag, the Process Metallurgy Module. The new module is designed for application to steelmaking and steel refining processes, including converters such as basic oxygen furnaces, electric arc furnaces, ladle furnace metallurgy, and more. The new Process Metallurgy Module makes it easy to define the composition of a steel and slag system because the calculator automatically provides the three common material groups, steel, slag, and gas, and provides default composition input types that are relevant to each material group. The new module also allows you to save your material compositions right from the calculator and quickly access them in the future. The Process Metallurgy Module allows users to predefine compositions of steels, ferroalloys, slags, and slag additions. The overall composition of the steel and slag is then obtained by simply adding amounts of these predefined materials. This opens up a whole range of powerful possibilities. Users who have the thermodynamic database TC-OX9 or TC-OX8 and a valid maintenance and support subscription receive the new module for free. All other users can test the module with the included OX demo database, which has been updated for the 2019B release to work with the new Process Metallurgy Module. Two examples demonstrating some of the applications of the Process Metallurgy Module are included in the 2019B release. These can be found in the Help menu, Examples Files, Process Metallurgy. Users with Thermo-Calc 2019B or newer can run the examples with the updated OX demo database. Additionally, we have created tutorial videos for the examples, which you can watch by clicking the links currently in the upper right-hand corner of the video or by visiting the video tutorials page on our website. The Steel Model Library introduces a template in Thermo-Calc 2019B, which sets up a time-temperature transformation diagram for the steel package. The new template is accessed from the home screen of Thermo-Calc and has several pre-configured settings that make it easy to set up and calculate the TTT diagram using the martensite temperatures and perlite property models. The template also comes with a new plotting mode called TTT mode, which is used to define the temperature on the y-axis and time on the x-axis for all selected quantities. For example, perlite will show transformation times for 2%, 50%, and 98% perlite. Time-independent results, like the MS temperature, will be drawn as a horizontal line. Use of the Steel Model Library, the new template, and the new TTT mode all require a valid maintenance and support subscription, plus licenses for the thermodynamic and kinetic steel databases, TC-FE9 and MOB-FE4. The Precipitation Module TC-PRISMA includes two new growth models in Thermo-Calc 2019B, para-equilibrium and non-partitioned local equilibrium. In a system where there are large differences between the diffusion rates of the components, there is a possibility to have fast reaction without the need of any redistribution of the more sluggish elements. In metals, the interstitial elements, such as carbon and nitrogen, are smaller than the metal atoms and diffuse much faster. The para-equilibrium and non-partitioned local equilibrium growth rate models are designed specifically to address the fast diffusing elements in iron alloys. A new example, P13, shows the new para-equilibrium growth model. The application for the new example is cementite precipitation at low temperatures for a steel. Users can access the new example in the Help menu, Examples Files, Precipitation Module. The part of the Thermo-Calc calculation engine known as the Gibbs Energy System Module, or GESS for short, has been completely rewritten for this release, from GESS 5 to GESS 6. The main purpose of GESS 6 is to support faster development of new features than is currently possible in GESS 5. However, GESS 6 does not yet support all the features of GESS 5, so GESS 5 and GESS 6 will coexist in the application for the foreseeable future. GESS 6 is enabled by default, but this can be changed by the user. The application will fall back gracefully and use GES 5 automatically in cases where certain functionality is not yet implemented in GES 6. See the Thermo-Calc 2019b release notes for further information on this. GES 6 has also shown improved calculation times for many long-running calculations, but for short calculations, the execution of GES 6 may be a little longer than for GES 5. This plot compares execution times between GES 5 and GES 6 from over 5,000 calculations on various industrial alloys. Calculation types include property diagrams, phase diagrams, and Scheil calculations. Points that are above the 1-to-1 ratio line show cases where GES 6 is slower than GES 5, and points that lie below the 1-to-1 ratio line show cases where GES 6 is faster than GES 5. Points on the 1-to-2 ratio line show cases where GES 6 is twice as fast as GES 5, and points on the 1-to-3 ratio line show cases where GES 6 is 3 times faster than GES 5. The orange symbols represent calculations using the TC-Nickel database, which tend to be more complex calculations. From this, we can see that these calculations tend to be 2-to-3 times faster than the corresponding calculations in GES 5. Some new features have been added to TC-Python in the 2019b release. It is now possible to set all options for each calculation type in a consistent way using the with_option method. Additionally, there is now a method on the system object that can convert between different composition units without performing an equilibrium calculation, making the conversion much faster. Also, TC-Python now uses GES 6 by default. The Diffusion module, DICTRA, has received some improvements in Thermo-Calc 2019b. Several numerical options are now set to automatic by default in both graphical and console modes, making it easier to perform common simulations. In graphical mode, you can now plot a coordinate inside a region, just like you can in console mode. This is done using the distance plot condition available on the plot renderer. In the console mode, a simplified setup of homogenization simulations was implemented. There is also a new comprehensive tutorial which teaches about the Diffusion module DICTRA and the role of diffusion in materials. Visit DICTRA.com to download the tutorial or click the link included in the description below. Thermo-Calc 2019b introduces 3 new databases and 2 updated databases. The thermodynamic database for metal oxide solutions, including slags, TCOX9, adds titanium, bringing it to a 25-element framework. The database also adds 19 binary systems, 26 ternary systems, and 30 quaternary systems. The database includes several other updates, some of which are listed on your screen. 2 new copper databases are released with Thermo-Calc 2019b. The thermodynamic copper database, TCCU3, and the companion mobility database, MobCU3. TCCU3 adds germanium, bringing it to a 30-element framework. 10 germanium binary systems are added, and 2 ternary systems are added. Volume data for the newly added phases are assessed or estimated. The companion mobility database, MobCU3, is updated to correspond to the updates in TCCU3. The steel and Fe alloys database, TCFE9, and the titanium database, TCTI2, have been updated with the improvements currently listed on the screen. To learn more about the 2019b release of Thermo-Calc, read the complete release notes by visiting our website or by clicking the link included in the video description below.